Mesoamerican cultures. As part of their funerary customs, typically deposited the dead in their tombs and graves with an abundance of ceramics and a diversity of other materials. As archaeological evidence, las culturas mesoamericanas, como parte de sus costumbres funerarias, típicamente depositaban a los muertos en sus tumbas y sepulcros, con abundante cerámica y diversidad de otros materiales. Como evidencia arqueológica, estos depósitos pueden decirnos mucho sobre las vidas anteriores de quienes habían sido enterrados y, en particular, indicar su creencia en el más allá y el tránsito sobrenatural de la riqueza material de un mundo al siguiente. As archaeological evidence, these deposits can tell us a great deal about the former lives of the interred, and in particular indicate their belief in the afterlife and the supernatural transit of material wealth from one world to the next. Funerary remains also speak to the needs of the living. Those who honor their ancestors with earthly offerings and strive to ensure a positive disposition toward their kin. Los restos funerarios también habían, Los restos funerarios también hablan de las necesidades de los vivos, aquellos que honran a sus antepasados con ofrendas terrenales y se esfuerzan por asegurar una disposición positiva a una disposición positiva de sus parientes. La relación entre las familias y sus antepasados es crucial, y puede ayudarnos a comprender el significado global del ajuar funerario y sus correspondientes cultos, así como los espacios que ocupan los muertos y los vivos en el duelo. The relationship between families and their ancestors is crucial and can help us comprehend the overall significance of grave goods and their corresponding cults, as well as the spaces occupied by the dead and by the living in bereavement. Oh. is Friday. Friday, the 9th of December, 37 minutes after the 15th hour from midnight. And it's also the 78th day of autumn. Scarcely 20 days left now before winter begins. Well, my Christmas present is I get to work on Mesoamerican archaeological writing and get paid a couple hundred dollars for it. It's the university, so they don't pay as much as Wall Street. So, actually, this book is not the university. This book is from a museum in Toronto, Ontario. A museum in Toronto, Ontario, the ROM. ROM. Yeah. Royal, I guess. Maybe it's regional. No, it's old enough to be called Royal. So it's the Royal Ontario Museum, and they got some bunch of people who putting out a series of essays, and we got hired to translate it from English into Spanish. And since I don't write Spanish very well, I write English pretty good, but I could read Spanish real good, and I can hear it, but I can't make up all the words for it because I don't know them all as well as my partner does. And this woman asked me to help her with this book. So I said, sure. I've worked with her before, so wasn't no big question in my mind about whether she's worth working with. I've known that for years. She's a good linguist. And I have a messy mustache. So anyhow, that's it for today. Just a little bit of what I need to get back to work on. Bye, my friend.